Before we start with practice set 8.2, there is this formula which I would like to discuss. It is nothing but the identity. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Now this is an identity, right? Which you have to remember, which we will be using it in our 9th standard. Now, there are two more identities which we won't be using in our 9th standard. But yes, 10th standard mein definitely wo use hone wale. So I won't be talking about those two identities now, right? I cannot shift the chair, child. I believe the paper is visible because if I try to shift the chair, the phone will basically come down. Wait, I'll just try though. Is it okay now? Yeah? Is that clear? Yeah. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. No, sir, it's blur. Sir, can I leave cos? I'm teaching 8.2. There are kids who are requesting me to zoom in. Is this fair enough? Is it clear enough now? Just let me know whether it is clear enough. Yes, yes, perfect. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1 is the identity which I want you all to remember, right? Practice set 8.2. Right? Question number 1. Now, yeah, children, I've said it. I'll repeat it once again. Those kids who have finished with this chapter in your semesters can leave, right? You need not attend this session. Now, it is up to you all if you want to attend though. But once you leave, just inform your center head that you have left for this particular reason because they'll be taking attendance. Yeah, I'll show you the identity. Don't worry about that. I wanted to talk about this question, children. So I'll just read the question. In the following table, a ratio is given in each column. Find the remaining two ratios in the column and complete the table. So every column here basically is nothing but a sum, right? So if I call it as sum number one, sub question one, this first column. Likewise, this has to be sub question two, sub question three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So there are 9 sub questions. All of them are done with similar method, right? So, aapko sirf ek ya do mein dhyan dena hai. Rest, you'll be able to do by yourselves, right? So, I'll just deal with the first one first. The first column to be precise. So, the first column, if you people have noticed, sine theta ka value, we need to find it. Tan theta ka value, we need to find it. And cos theta is 35 upon 37. So first sub question, cos theta is given to us. 35 upon 37. Right? And we need to find sine and tan. Now children, remember the method which I'll be using for this particular sum. I call it as triangle method. Now, why triangle method? Because I need to draw a triangle by myself in order to complete the sum. So I draw a beautiful right angled triangle. I name it as A, B, C. You could have named it as anything like LMN, PQR, whatever you want. Right? Either angle A ko theta represent karo or angle C ko theta represent karo. You have a choice. So let's say I've represented angle C as theta, right? I mark cos theta, which is 35 upon 37 as equation 1 because that is given. Now children, as per the ratio, the formula which we spoke in the last class, cos theta ka ratio kya hai? Adjacent upon hypotenuse, right? Adjacent side upon hypotenuse, right? So the adjacent side to theta, can somebody help me with that? T टीटा के लिए एडजेसेंट साइड कौन सा होने वाला है यहाँ पर? परफेक्ट, इट हैज टू बी बी सी, दैट इज करेक्ट. सो हम अपॉन द हाइपोटेन्यूस इज ऑलवेज साइड ऑपोजिट टू 90 डिग्री विच इज ए सी, राइट? सो बी सी अपॉन ए सी, दिस इज कॉस थीटा. आई मार्क इट एज इक्वेशन टू. नाउ हैव अ लुक एट इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू, राइट? सब लोग इक्वेशन वन एंड इक्वेशन टू को देखो. दोनों का लेफ्ट हैंड साइड्स आर दे इक्वल? So if the left hand sides of two equations are equal, what can we state about the right hand sides, children? Agar left hand sides equal hai, to right hand sides bhi equal hai. That means BC upon AC, right, is equals to 35 upon 37. Now in maths, whenever we have a ratio, right, first thing that comes to our mind, first thing that comes to our mind is that let the common multiple be x, right? Let the common multiple be, now instead of x you can use any variable. Most of the school teachers for this particular sums, they use K and they call it as K method. I don't know why, but they do it that way. It is absolutely okay if you use some other variable, right? For example, I'll be using X here, right? So let the common multiple be X. So BC ka value has to be 35X, kyunki BC ke opposite mein 35 hai. So children, BC is 35X. Right, and AC ka value has to be 37x. I hope that is clear. So I'll just mark those values here in the figure. BC 35x, AC 37x. Now tell me, since I know two sides ka values, can I find third side ka value? The question is how, if yes. Perfect. Soham says Pythagoras theorem, right? Rithi has also said Pythagoras and Sai has also said Pythagoras. Shivashri is also correct. So children, we need to apply Pythagoras here. I hope everybody knows how to apply Pythagoras. Yeah, correct. So I want you all to copy this much, the figure as well. Ye pura copy karo and then apply Pythagoras and tell me what is the value of AB. Fir uske aage kya karna hai? I'll help you there, right? So just copy this. Be very quick. And complete Pythagoras theorem as well. Sorry. Yeah, somebody says it is 12. I'll have to check Deep. Yeah, that's correct. It is 12x. I hope you kids have written the presentation correctly. And you finished copying this as well. It is not 12, Susan. It is 12x. Yeah, it's okay. Just correcting you. Yeah. So I believe most of the kids might have finished copying this. The figure as well. The figure is compulsory, right? Yeah. Yeah. So just moving on to the next part. Now, applying Pythagoras, I would like to apply Pythagoras in triangle A, B, सी मेजर एंगल ए बी सी इज इक्वल्स टू 90 डिग्री दैट इज गिवन टू अस एंड देयरफॉर अप्लाइंग पाइथागोरस हाइपोटेन्यूस स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू साइड वन स्क्वायर प्लस साइड टू स्क्वायर बाय पाइथागोरस थ्योरम राइट नाउ एसी का वैल्यू वाज 37 एक्स द होल स्क्वायर एबी का वैल्यू वी नीडेड टू फाइंड इट एंड बीसी का वैल्यू वाज 35 एक्स द होल स्क्वायर राइट नाउ देयर आर टू ऑप्शंस आइदर यू कैन स्क्वायर दोस एंड देन सब्ट्रैक्ट दोस गेट द आंसर और The second option is I'll be shifting this 35 x square on the other side. So that makes it in the form of an identity. What identity? A square minus B square. I hope everybody remembers the formula for A square minus B square. It is A minus B into A plus B, right? You can do it by squaring way as well, whatever way you like. Since a square minus b square is a minus b into a plus b. Now, 37 minus 35, children, the answer is 2x. 37 plus 35, it is 72, right? Now, when you multiply this, 72 into 2 is 144. X into X is X square. So just like taking square root on both the sides. Taking square roots on both the sides. What we have is 12X is equals to AB. You may put it as units if you want. Right? So AB is equals to 12x units since it is a distance equation I don't know we use two equations right so this is equation 3 Ishan is asking me which problem set sum is this Ishan this is question number 1 ka first sub question Himesh, you already gave me answer for this sum. I have just applied Pythagoras, beta. Pythagoras apply kiya, usme aap log itna confused ho gaye. Himesh ka to maine answer bhi padha tha. I hope everybody knows how they got 12x, right? Aur ek baar 12x mila. Now, if you kids remember, cos theta milne ke baad, we needed to find sin theta and tan theta. AB mil chuka hai, right? AB, we have got it as 12x. So, in order to find sin theta, what is the ratio for sin theta? It is opposite upon hypotenuse. So, it has to be 12x upon 37x. I hope that is clear. And then tan theta has to be opposite upon adjacent. That is 12 upon 35. That easy. So, I'll just write here sin theta is equals to opposite side upon hypotenuse which is opposite ho gaya AB upon AC AB upon AC I hope you kids can see this AB ka value is 12x and AC ka value was 37x x gets cancelled definitely here the reason has to be from 3 So the answer is 12 upon 37. That is your sin theta. Right? The next part we needed to find tan theta as well. So tan theta ka formula, the ratio was opposite side upon adjacent side. Right, children? So opposite side ka name hai AB. Adjacent side is BC. So that is 12x upon 35x. Again from 3. XX gets cancelled. The answer is 12 upon 35. And that is our final answer. आई होप एवरीबडी हैज अंडरस्टूड इट. या सो जस्ट कॉपी दिस पार्ट. आई बिलीव एवरीबडी हैज फिनिश्ड पाइथागोरस राइट. No, it cannot be minus 12 here. It cannot be minus 12 because it is a distance. It has to be positive. And it is equal to child. Wo equal to ka ek line has coincided with this line. If you meant this. माइनस कैसे आएगा लॉजिकली तू ही देखना. एक्स एक्स कट तो 12 अपॉन 37 या आई बिलीव यू मस्ट हैव फिनिश्ड फर्स्ट फ्यू स्टेप्स. सो आई विल जस्ट मूव दिस पेज स्लाइटली अपवर्ड्स. Okay, by the way, children, the same sum can be done with one more method, right? There are certain schools who use the other method. There are certain schools who follow this. If you ask me ki kaun sa method follow karna chahiye, I would say go for triangle method. It's absolutely okay if we go with a method which uses this identity. I'll show you an example. Like the same sum, I'll be solving with the help of this identity, right? So you don't have to copy it, though you should know how to deal with it, right? So again, the same question with another method based on identity, right? So cos theta is 35 upon 37. I marked it as equation 1. Now, I'll use the identity. It is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. I'll substitute the value of cos theta here in this equation. So this becomes sine square theta plus cos theta ka value is 35 upon 37. Now since it is cos square, it has to be the whole square is equals to 1. So 35 ka square. Can somebody help me with the value of 35 ka square if you've done it? Yeah, you can do direct squaring method. I said it deep already. Can somebody help me with 35? Yeah, thank you, Razel. It is 1, 2, 2, 5. And what is 37 ka square? 1, 3, 6, 9. Yeah, amazing. Is equals to 1, right? Therefore, sine square theta is equals to, I'll shift this number on the other side. Since the sign is positive, on the other side, it will be negative. But I'll first write this 1 minus 1225 upon 1369, right? I hope everybody understands what is the next step. It has to be cross multiplication. Achha, 1 ke niche kuch nahi hai, matlab there is a 1, right? And then you cross multiply. So 1369 into 1. So this is the equal to sign in case. Yeah, 1369 into 1 is 1369 minus. Yaha pe jo 1 tha, 1 into 1225 is 1225 upon 1 into 1369 is again 1369. I hope everybody has understood this step. If any student has any sorts of doubt in this step, please ask. Right? Yeah. None. So when you subtract those, the answer is 144 upon 1369. Takshila Sai says, please explain again. Yeah. Sai, just pay attention, child. This part, you know, I can write this 1 as 1 upon 1, right? Minus 1225 upon 1369. So the first thing in cross multiplication, child, we do is we multiply this two. So 1 into 1369 is 1369, right? Then अगर यहां पर ऑपरेटर माइनस है तो हम माइनस लिखेंगे, राइट? अगर यहां पर ऑपरेटर प्लस है तो हम प्लस लिखेंगे. देन 1 into 1225, वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस टू, देन सो 1 into 1225 इज 1225, राइट? अपॉन पार्थ, आई हैव रेडी योर मैसेज, आई विल रिप्लाई, डोंट वरी. लेट मी जस्ट कंक्लूड दिस फर्स्ट. 1 into 1369, राइट, इज 1369. एट द एंड वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस टू, सो 1369. दिस इज हाउ आई गॉट दिस स्टेप, राइट? So just ignore this part. That is again the re-explanation. I hope the kid who asked has understood now. Yeah. Now Parth, to you. Parth has asked me a question saying, sir, why can't we cancel 1369, 1369? Because in the numerator, we have a binomial. And in the denominator, we have a monomial. See, it is something like this, kid. It is like A minus B upon A. You cannot cancel A and A. In order to cancel, it has to be the same binomial upon same binomial or same monomial upon same monomial. I hope it is clear. It is a separate term. Yes. The terms are either separated by a negative sign or a positive sign. I hope you kids know that. Isn't it? So, two terms ho gaye. So, binomial upon monomial, you cannot cancel it. You can separate it something like this. A upon A minus B upon A. Then, since it is monomial upon monomial, you may cancel it. Right? So, agar vaisa kuch karoge, to aap vapas ye step pe aa jaoge. If you separate it like this and then you cancel 1369, 1369, you'll get this step. I hope it is clear. Yeah. So, just ignore those two parts. Those were explanations. Pay attention here now. I believe everybody has understood now. Parth, I hope I cleared your doubt. Now, since this is sine square theta, and I do realize that 144 is a perfect square, 1369 is a perfect square, taking square root on both sides, sine square theta will become sine theta. 144 ka ho jayega 12, 1369 will become 37. Taking square root. Samuel, it is up to you all. Child, this is the second method. So, it is up to you all whether you want to copy it or not. You may take a screenshot if you want. Right? I'll show you the sums part by part. As of now, let me explain things. So, children, I have got sine theta. I have got cos theta. We also need to find tan theta, if you all remember. And in the last class, we studied a direct relation, a formula which linked tan theta, sine theta, and cos theta. It was tan theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta. I hope you kids remember it, right? So, sine theta ka value, kids, we got it as 12 upon 37. Sir, why 12 minus 2? Hey, minus 2 nahi hai, child. That is equation 2. That is my way of writing it. Do not misread it as minus 2. It is equation 2 since this was equation 1, right? Yeah. So, sine theta is 12 upon 37. 12 upon 37 divided by cos theta. Now, what is cos theta ka value? It was given to us as 35 upon 37. Right? 35 upon 37. So, I'll just put the reason as from 1 and 2. Because ye 1 se aya hai aur ye 2 se. Achha, children, can I write this fraction, yani numerator upon denominator? Can I write this fraction upon fraction as 12 upon 37 divided by 35 upon 37. Isse na easy ho jata hai. Perfect. And then reciprocal. Absolutely correct. So it is 12 upon 37, division changes to multiplication. And as soon as division changes to multiplication, the second ratio uska reciprocal kar deta. 37 upon 35. 37, 37 will get cancelled. So what is left is 12 upon 35. And that is tan theta. So this is the second method for the same sum. So I've shown you both the methods. Right? Now those kids who want to, yeah, both are easy. I'll tell you second sum, second method basically. Yeah, it is exactly the same though. Certain sums you might find it difficult. So it is up to you. You'll get full marks either ways. But there are certain school teachers who are adamant saying we need triangle method. There are certain teachers who are adamant saying we need the second method. So I've taught both of them. Jo school mein jo bola jayega, you may just follow that. Soham, both the methods are applicable in 10th, though majorly this one is followed in 10th. Anyways, you do any, it's absolutely okay for 10th standard. You won't lose any marks. So you may take a screenshot if you want for this particular method. I'll just keep this for a few seconds. Then I'll just move the screen in downward direction. I'll just count till 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah, I'll move in the upward direction now. So here is this part. You can just take a screenshot of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then the last part. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah. I would recommend the triangle method. Anyways, both are absolutely fine. It is up to you all. Right? So, we have dealt with the first sum. Now, I would like to deal with third sum. Let's say. Right? So, question number one. Ka third sum. You kids tell me which method should I deal this sum with respect to. Like, the triangle method or the identity method. Or don't call first method, second method. Name it as triangle method or the identity method. Susan says triangle. There are a few kids saying triangle, few kids saying identity. Majority of them are referring to triangle. So I'll just follow the triangle method here. Yeah, I'll draw a beautiful triangle, children. P, Q, R, right? I'll use the formula, the ratio tan theta, which is opposite side upon adjacent side, right? So the opposite side to theta, let's say this is 90 and this is theta. Theta ke liye opposite side kaun ho jayega? PQ, adjacent side QR. So that's my equation 2. Now look at equation 1 and 2. Dono ka left hand side is equal. Hai. So children, since the left hand sides are equal, I state the right hand sides are also equal. So that means PQ upon QR is equals to 1. Achha, equal to 1 hai. Matlab, I can call it as 1 upon 1. Right? If I wanted that way, right? So, since I have a ratio, 1 upon 1 can be considered as a ratio, I can put it as let the common multiple be, just to get used to it. Few school teachers might use this alphabet K. So, PQ is 1k and QR will also be 1k. Instead of 1x, it is 1k. Nothing new. So PQ is 1k, QR is 1k. Can we find PR? Yes, by Pythagoras, right? So I want you all to copy this much. Go ahead and deal with Pythagoras. Let me know what is the value for PR. Now for this sum, I won't be, you know, solving the sum with the other method. The next few sums, either I'll do triangle method or identity method. Yeah, that is correct, Deep. I hope you kids have finished copying. Yeah, that is root 2k. Perfect. It is root 2k. K jo hai, wo root ke bahar hoga. Yeah, I'll show you something like this. In triangle PQR, angle PQR is 90, PQ is 1K, QR is 1K. So 1 ka square is 1, that becomes 1K square plus 1K square. So that is like 2K square, right children? So PR square is equals to 2K square. Then taking square root on both the sides, right? Yeah, taking square roots on both the sides, PR is equals to, acha, 2 ka root nahi nikal paega, so it will remain root 2. K square ka root has to be K. So it is like root 2 K. Do not just show the sign and draw it forward, because that will be like under root 2 K. It is root 2 into K, right? Units, and that be our equation 3. It is not minus, it is equation 3. Now, since I've got value for PR now, which is root 2 K, we can find whatever needed, like tan theta pata hai, we can find sine and cos. Sine theta has to be opposite upon hypotenuse, cos theta has to be adjacent upon hypotenuse. Both the answers would be 1 upon root 2. Yeah, so sine theta will be opposite side upon hypotenuse side, which is PQ upon PR. PQ ka value is 1K and PR ka value is root 2 K, right? From 3. KK gets cancelled. So the answer is 1 upon root 2, which is sine theta. Similarly, we can find cos theta. I hope you can find cos theta on your own. Please do it. Kindly finish off the sum and just let me know once you are done. Kindly cross-check the presentation if you have missed anything. Right, 1 upon root 2. Perfect. Yeah, so we move on to basically the last sub question maybe. So I've completed first, I've completed third, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, the ninth sub question I'm talking about in the table, the ninth column, the last column. It says tan theta is 1 upon 2 root 2. So again, there are two options with us. Either we can use the identity method or we can use the triangle method. I would like to go ahead with the identity method here. I can do either. That is up to you. In order to use identity here, the first thing which I'll have to start with is that tan theta is nothing but sine theta upon cos theta, right? I mark it as my equation 2. Now, comparing equation 1 and 2, dono ka left hand sides equal, so right hand sides be equal. Sine theta upon cos theta is equals to 1 upon 2 root 2 from 1 and 2. I hope this everybody has understood it. Any doubts till now? Yeah, perfect. Samuel says do with the triangle method. Samuel, I can do it, but the only problem is it would need more time for me. Let me complete this since I've already started with this method. I'll try to get it done with the triangle method as well. Yeah. So let the common multiple be x. Right? So that means sine theta ka value has to be 1x. Sine theta has to be 1x and cos theta ka value has to be 2 root 2x. Cos theta has to be 2 root 2x, right? So now I'll be using the identity, children, which is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to, what is sine theta ka value? 1x. So I'll just substitute that value. 1x the whole square plus, what is cos theta ka value? 2 root 2 x the whole square is equals to 1. Very sorry. Yeah. 1 ka square is 1. X ka square is x square. Plus 2 ka square is 4. Root 2 ka square is 2, because root 2 into root 2 is 2. X ka square is x square and this is 1. Right? So that makes it x square plus 4 to the 8 x square is equals to 1. Children, what is 8 plus 1 x square? 8 x square plus 1 x square. It becomes perfect. 9 x square, right? Is equals to 1. Now I shift this 9 on the other side. Since it is 9x square, 9 or x square ke beech mein kuch nahi hai, matlab multiplication hai. So multiplication udhar jayega to it will get divided. 1 upon 9. This is upon, right? Yeah. So x square is 1 upon 9. Taking square root, I mean, 1 ka root is 1, 9 ka root is 3. So taking square root on both the side, right? Now children, we have got x ka value. I mark maybe this as our equation 3. Perfect. Yeah, x ka value milne ke baad, our aim is to find sine theta and cos theta. So sine theta, we all know, is 1x. Sine theta is nothing but 1x. So that will be 1 into 1 upon 3 from 3, right? Okay, x ka value 1 upon 3. So the answer is 1 upon 3 for sine theta. Next part. We needed to find cos theta as well, right? Cos theta ka value kya hai? 2 root 2x. cos theta is equals to 2 root 2 x. So that is like 2 root 2 into, ये मैंने into लिखा है, x नहीं है, because इसके बीच में into है. X का value क्या है? 1 upon root 3 from equation 1. So 1 upon root 3, sorry, from equation 3. Right. So it would be like 2 root 2 into 1 is 2 root 2. So that's 2 root 2 upon 3. That will be the answer for cos theta. That's it. I hope everybody has understood the sum. Just let me know if you need to copy it. I mean, from the start. There might be kids who haven't copied it, right? So here is the sum. Start copying it. Is there any kid still, including Samuel, who needs me to deal with this sum with the triangle method? Wow, there are a few kids who are done with. Anishka says yes. Samuel has already said a yes or triangle method. Yeah, just let me know once you people are done copying this. Those kids who are copying. Few kids saying not needed. You saying Anishka saying and the other kid. Yeah, Sharanya saying it. I'll try that. Yeah, I'll just slightly keep on moving the page in the upward direction. Assuming. Yeah, Suzanne, I'll deal with that because I saw there were few kids who are requesting for triangle method. Yeah, it's like an automatic scroll. Yeah, Sai, you may try. It's absolutely fine. If you're finished copying, you may just go ahead and try the triangle method. Anyway, since few kids have requested, I'll deal with the triangle method as well. And then the rest of the sums, you'll have to deal with those anyways at home. Right? Yeah, I'll help you. Don't worry. The same sum I'll deal in the triangle method as well. If there is any kid who haven't finished copying things, let me know. Okay, Sandhya. Okay, Prapti is finished. Yeah, mostly the class will be done because it is already 5:45. Kuch time bacha to dekhenge aur. I'll add few sums as homework. Jo method aaj padha hai uske basis pe. Yeah, I hope everybody has finished. Yeah, so moving on to the same sub method 2, that is triangle method. It was tan theta, which was 1 upon 2 root 2. Equation 1, as I said, we can draw a right angle triangle. You can give it any name. Just say, for instance, I call it as L M N. 90 degree, this is theta. Right. So tan theta ka ratio is opposite side upon adjacent side, that is LM upon MN, right? Equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, dono ka left hand side is equal hai, to right hand side bhi equal hai. So from 1 and 2, LM upon MN is equals to 1 upon 2 root 2. Right? Let the common multiple be x. Let the common multiple be x, right? Therefore, LM is supposed to be 1x and MN is supposed to be 2 root 2 x. So 2 root 2 x is MN and LM is 1x. So we need to find LN, the third side, by Pythagoras theorem, right? I hope you all can deal with Pythagoras theorem. In fact, those kids who have requested this method, I request you to take a screenshot of this. I'll just immediately move ahead and deal with Pythagoras. I'll count till 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah. Moving ahead. In triangle LMN, angle LMN is equals to 90 degrees, that is given to us. Yeah, Susan, let me verify it for you. LN square is equals to LM square plus MN square by Pythagoras theorem, right? Now, LN ka value, we don't know it, so I'll keep it as it is. LM ka value is 1x the whole square plus MN ka value is 2 root 2 x the whole square, right? So that has to be x square plus 2 ka square is 4, root 2 ka square is 2, and that is x square. Ye maine into likha hai, just that you be pretty much sure, right? This is into. So x square plus 4 2 is 8 into x square is like 8x square, right? So x square plus 8x square is 9x square, because x square ke aage 1 hai. Taking square root, ln has to be 3x. I mark this is our equation 3. Now, children, once I know ln, can I find the other two terms? Yes. Sine theta is nothing but opposite side upon hypotenuse side. The opposite side, children, was LM. The hypotenuse side is LN. So LM ka value is 1x upon, sorry, 1x upon LN ka value is 3x from equation 3. X gets cancelled. The answer is 1 upon 3, right? Likewise, you can very easily find, yeah, it's absolutely okay if you use both the methods in 10th standard. I mean, any method is absolutely fine in 10th. Ninth mein school teachers adamant hote hai. Like certain school teachers, they follow triangle method. Certain school teachers, they follow only identity method. And 10th mein, mostly identity method follow hota hai. Right? Yeah, cos theta, I want you all to find it for yourselves. You can just take a screenshot of this. I believe this you have already taken, right? Yeah, so here is the last part. And just finish off the sum. It is 5:51, still 9 minutes left. I believe we can deal with one more sum here. Or rather, let's say I would like to reduce your homework here. Yeah, Mansi, I'll do that. Saidariam. Yeah, here is the first page. Be very quick. Daniel, I'll let you know. Just give me a moment. Yeah, I'll explain that to you, Shivashri. Just give me a moment. Here is the second half of the first page. Okay. Yeah, I'll just help you with cos theta as well. Page bhi khatam ho gaya mera, so I'll continue with the sum next time with a new book. But let me just give you homework. Don't run away. Adjacent side upon hypotenuse, right? So the adjacent side is MN. And the hypotenuse is LN. MN upon LN. Ab MN ka value was 2 root 2x. And LN ka value was 3x. XX gets cancelled. This is from 3. So that is 2 root 2 upon 3, the final answer for cos theta. Now, Shivashri, what you asked, right, was this part. He, sir, how 2 root 2 into 1 upon root 3 is this, correct? What happens is, yaha par, since the operator is multiplication and not addition or subtraction, jab plus ya minus hota hai, beta, to we cross multiply, the part which I explained earlier. बट जब मल्टीप्लीकेशन होता है तो डायरेक्टली न्यूमरेटर न्यूमरेटर से मल्टीप्लाई होता है और डिनोमिनेटर डिनोमिनेटर से राइट सो दिस बिकम्स 2 रूट 2 इनटू 1 एनीथिंग इनटू 1 इज दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग लाइक 2 वन जा 2 3 वन जा 3 4 वन जा 4 सो 2 रूट 2 इनटू 1 इज 2 रूट 2 लाइकवाइज 1 इनटू 3 इज 3 शिवाश्री समझा आई होप शिवाश्री इज देयर Shivashri, I explained cross multiplication sirf tabhi hota hai when the operator is either plus addition or subtraction. Ye rules hai, basic conventions jo maths ke hote hai. So you have to remember that. Right? Yeah, I'll just add homework here. See, I have completed the first column, that is first sub-question, third sub-question, and nine sub-question, right? So I would expect you kids to complete question number one ka second sub-question, yani second column, fourth column, fifth column, sixth column, seventh, and eighth column as well. Now it is your choice what method you want to use. Right? Triangle ya jo bhi hai. This is from practice set 8.2. Now, wait. There is more to it. Kyunki sare similar sums. Yahan par agar aap dekhoge sin theta ka value given hai, cos pucha hai. Simple hai, identity use karo. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Substitute sine theta, you'll be finding cos. The same goes here. Right? So, simple identity use karo. The sums are done. So, question main question 3, main question 4 will be homework. Main question 3, main question 4. So, this sums will be homework. If I want the next class, I will not teach anything. I'll just check. That depends upon me completely. If I'm in the mood, I will not teach in the next class. I'll just ask each and every kid to show the video, put the video on and show me the book. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So 8 sums as homework, right? I've just taken the screenshot of this. Thank you so much, children. God bless you all. I'll just stop here.